it really began, this last 10 years, this movement of the Holy Spirit began with a prayer walk up Mount Kilimanjaro. And out of that walk came this vision for reaching young people, and a vision that has fueled us for this 10 years and has helped us go from 4 or 5 clubs in one city in one country to 21 countries and thousands of kids involved. As the leadership of Young Life Africa has prayed about reaching the world of kids in Africa, what God wants us to do next, because we want to get the next kid, that God has led us to this, to open the way for kids to experience freedom and come to know Jesus.
My hope that this war brings freedom.
We see a future is coming, like a cloud coming to bring water. I see hope in this walk.
So this walk is along the slave caravan route. This was the route where probably 15 million Africans walked with chains around their necks, sweating, crying, and blood soaking the trail, bodies littering the side. This trail was the artery for the slave trade.
God wants us to walk the same route with the opposite mind, not chained, but to dechain all that the devil has chained for many years.
So every step is a step putting my foot down, claiming, you know, all the joy and all the love and all the freedom that Christ had intended that we lost along the way.
Those kind of things that have the continent and young people in this continent shackled, that artery needs to be unclogged for us to begin to reach kids at this next level, deeper and wider into the heart of Africa, especially as we move in to harder to reach places.
We are walking, releasing the power of God.
We are the ministry that goes. Who better to take those steps and go than us?
We need to make sure no kids ever walk in chains ever again. Freedom is the one thing that I want to carry with me every time I meet a kid. You know, because I know that is what Young Life has helped me get more than anything else.
It is about meeting people, blessing them, pray for them, and find people who love Young Life and start ministries in some of their towns.
We've never done anything like this, so we wanted a trial run.
We wanted to walk 15 kilometers into Bagamoyo. We prayed for people. We met Paul.
And when I was walking, I met this young man and asked me, what is this walk about? And I was explaining to him that we are walking, praying for young people to be responsible and if they could follow Christ. Then he said he wanted to know more about Christ from me. And I shared with him about the stories of Jesus Christ. So when we got at the cross at Bagamoyo, he was still with me.
At the place where slaves were sold and sent to Zanzibar, Paul claimed freedom in Christ. He accepted Jesus Christ.
I think he felt the freedom. He's no longer an outsider. He's included in this group of believers.
That moment was powerful. Paul's life was changed. And we feel like that was God pulling back the veil, letting us know what he's going to be up to on this walk. Real clubs will begin. Real kids will hear about Jesus. Real lives will be changed. And maybe along that corridor, real leadership will be raised up that will change their villages and their communities in Africa.
Join into this. Let everyone who has ever felt slavery, or even if you feel enslaved in anything in your life, this is a work for you. And together we'll see Africa and yourself free in the Lord.